What's going on? This is going to be a little bit of a different video. It's going to be more of a story time about how I made national team. I'm born and raised in Calgary, Alberta, and grew up skiing at COP. With my dad working at COP growing up, I spent a lot of time skiing there, and I started skiing at COP when I was 2 years old. My dream to become an athlete started in about 2004 when I saw Kyle Schufelt win gold in gymnastics at the Athens Olympics.
Double twisting, double tuck. Absolutely nailed. Beautiful work from Schufelt.
After he won his gold medal, he came home to Calgary and did this little welcome home thing at COP. And I remember watching that and being super interested by it and wanting to be able to do that one day for myself. After watching that, I knew I wanted to go to the Olympics one day. I just never knew what sport and how I would want to do it. I started freestyle skiing at about the age of 6, doing like a Nancy Green and Jumps and Bumps program at COP. And that's where I ended up falling in love with freestyle skiing. With my dad working at COP, all I wanted to do is just go skiing. So after school every single day, I would go skiing at COP and still do the freestyle programs on the other nights of the week. Me enjoying freestyle at that point, I decided to enter a couple of competitions, just a couple club comps. I remember one of my first ones was in Red Deer Canyon, so I did that one, and just a couple little ones at COP, little club comps. But those were the first competitions I'd ever done in skiing. I remember after a couple years of doing club comps, we went to Jasper, and that's where I won my first competition ever. I won a club comp in Jasper, and it was one of the coolest feelings I've had. Just knowing that the run that you skied was the best one down that course all day. That's probably one of the reasons why I really got into it. It really helped me fall in love with the sport, because that was sort of the beginning for me for sure. Like, I never had mogul skis growing up, never had like the nicest skis or the nicest goggles or any of that sort of stuff. And this comp I won on some super old park skis that literally the edges I like screwed back together like just that week before that event. Even though I didn't have the nicest things, I just really liked skiing. I really liked skiing moguls. I think that's one of the key points that set me on this path. At this point, I'm a few years into some programs at COP, just generic freestyle programs. You know, I'm sure if you skied moguls and grew up skiing moguls, you know that all the kids just want to ski park. That's kind of the cool thing to do at the moment, is going into like slopestyle and stuff like that. So when I was growing up, there was never really a strong mogul program or any mogul program at all at COP. So that was one of the big obstacles I had to overcome here. I remember lots of nights where I would go to my freestyle program and nobody would ever want to ski moguls except for me, and I'd come home kind of sad because I'd always wanted to ski moguls. I never knew that I wanted to become a mogul skier at that point, but just that I really enjoyed skiing moguls, and it's kind of just what I wanted to do at that time. Tried to set in motion a mogul team for COP because I had a slopestyle team and a halfpipe team. At that point, I had been training with Chip all summer long on the airbag. Chip helped me out a lot when I was younger. He taught me my first backflips, front flips, cork sevens, and all those things. So he was a huge help in my early days of freestyle skiing and really getting me into the sport. He was a huge idol. In those early days at COP, we had coaches like Courtney and Megan, Mike Hayde, Ken Rhodes, and now we have Murray Clough. During this time on the windsport team, I was in high school at Wiliam Aberheart in Calgary. I never went to a sports school or anything like that because I was taking French immersion, and if I went to a sports school, it'd mean I would have to drop my French immersion. And at that point, I was already like 9 years into doing French immersion, so I figured I might as well just do the last three and get the diploma for it. This is where I really started to fall in love with working out. I had a couple teachers like Mr. and Mrs. Peterson from Aberheart who really got me into working out and a healthy lifestyle. I'd show up at school at like 6:30 every single day to go work out. Before classes started, Mr. Peterson, one of the gym teachers, would always work out with us in the morning. He'd open the gym up for us, and it'd be a small group of us out coming in to work out. That's really where I fell in love with working out and like living a healthy lifestyle and eating well. When I was younger, I used to be kind of a chubby kid, I guess you could say. I always struggled with school. School is never my forte. Never been super great at like reading, writing, any of that stuff. So it was definitely hard for me going through school while trying to follow my passion for skiing at the same time, but I made it work. I did have like an IPP in school, which is just basically I can help me with reading and writing and like writing tests and that sort of thing. It was never an easy thing for me, school, especially in high school. It was something I always had to work hard at. Throughout high school, I never really had very many friends either. I had maybe 2 friends in high school. Most days I would eat my lunch alone. I don't really know why, just I was so into working out at that time, and that was really my main focus, was working out and eating well, and obviously trying to finish high school while skiing. As a kid growing up, I was never the best skier either. Like, I never was that kid that would win provincials every single year, or like every single time, which absolutely dominated provincials. Like, I was probably 6th, 7th, around that in provincials growing up. Never like stole the show. I was never that kind of kid that blew everybody out of the water. Like I said, I wasn't the most athletic kid. I had always done a lot of sports and like played a lot of sports and would always do activities with my family growing up, but it was just something that just never came easily to me, athletics. I was never the fastest kid. I was never the strongest kid. Yeah, I had to work really hard for everything. I grew up around some skiers that were super talented, like Julian and Davis and Ryan Portello, and watching those guys ski when they were younger, like, they were super, super good. And I always really looked up to them. But again, at that time, when I was in high school and like I said, not winning all the provincials or Canadian series or anything like that, the one thing that I had going for me was that I worked really hard. Nobody worked harder than me. Like, there's a lot of really, really talented skiers that I was around, but nobody was able to work as hard as me. And honestly, I wouldn't have it any other way than that, because I really believe that me having to work really hard to get to the place I am now, I believe that me not being the most talented person is one of the key factors that allowed me to get to where I am now. I'm having to work really hard in school, having to work really hard in skiing, having to work really hard in the gym, in all of athletics. I believe that's a huge factor in the reason why I am where I am today. I wouldn't have that any other way. Fast forward 3 years, I graduate high school, get my French diploma. I did end up going back for one semester of high school just to do a couple courses that if I ever want going to university at some point that I would need to get in. And that's something that I'm super proud of, because obviously that didn't come super easy to me. It's something I had to work really hard at. I did 2 NORAMS on my grade 12 year with Murray. One in Calgary was my first one, and one in Val-Saint-Côme, Quebec was my second one. Both of them I ended up blowing out or crashing on, but they're my first 2 that I've ever done, so it was a first step. That was my first year out of high school, and I'm on the Alberta team. Ed was the head coach this year, so I train all summer with him and end up going to all 4 NORAMs that year. The first one was in Killington, where I blew out. The second one was in Val-Saint-Côme, where I crashed. The third one was in North Star, California, where I crashed. And then finally, it's the last NORAM of the year. At this point, I'm 5 NORAMs in, all crashing, still have yet to complete a single run, still have yet to land a run. Just haven't even put down any run yet in any NORAM. It's been a year and a half of skiing NORAMs. It's the last NORAM of the year at Apex, a course I know pretty well. That's where I finally skied my first top to bottom in a NORAM. It was nothing special by any means, but just skiing a top to bottom at that point really meant a lot. It was pretty hard crashing that many times and just not really knowing what's going wrong, but stuck with it and finally landed a top to bottom at a NORAM. So now it's my second year in Alberta team. This year we had Jim Sheeman as our head coach. It was a good summer, trained all summer long. Going to the season again, feeling pretty good, you know, landed my first NORAM run last year, so feeling like this could be the year where I put down some good runs and get some results hopefully. So I go into the first NORAM of the year at Val-Saint-Côme, Quebec again, and I go into bottom air on one my duels. It was a duel I was clearly gonna win, so I don't really know why I did this, but I just thought that I had to put down a big enough back cross for the next couple runs, so I wanted to get a practice one in going big for bottom air. And then I kind of lose it, crash, fall throughout the whole finish section, end up in the finish area, and I ended up breaking my hand. I also tweaked my knee this year. Now I have a broken hand, tweaked knee, can't compete. I missed 2 NORAMs, and then I end up in Park City, Utah for the last NORAM of the year. Hand still in a cast, not fully healed. I had been skiing a little bit of COP, just like without poles, just doing some turns, keeping it pretty easy. And now I have to ski moguls in Park City with poles for the first time, but I just really needed to put down a good run and try and get a result here. So going into that event, I was a little bit stressed. Like, I knew nothing was gonna come of that year. I'd already missed 2 NORAMs. Nothing huge was gonna happen out of that, but I just really wanted to get a good result. Like, I'd been on NORAMs for 3 years now, never made finals, never really had a great finish at all. So then going to this event with a broken hand, and I end up making finals and getting 15th. I was super stoked. A huge, well-needed confidence boost for me, especially after that season. Feeling good coming in, breaking my hand, and then ending up at least getting one finals under my belt. Felt pretty good. At this point, I've been on Alberta team for 2 years. The last 2 years, I got an invite to Junior World Champs at the end of the year. First one was in Valmalenko, Italy, and the second one was in RA, Sweden. They're probably one of the coolest events I've ever been to. They're Junior World Champs, so it's classified as a World Champs event, or it's all the best skiers in the entire world under 19 years old. So first time really skiing in a fully international event, including the entire world. That was a super cool experience. Yeah, I would 10 out of 10 recommend for anybody if they have the chance to go. Would definitely recommend going to Junior Worlds. I ended up placing 6th and 7th in Italy for Junior Worlds, and then also ended up placing 7th in Sweden for Junior Worlds as well. At this point, this is my third year on a provincial team, 3 years out of high school. Got a new coach, Rob Kober, who was coaching national team for the last 16 years. Helped Mick win countless gold medals, countless World Cup medals, Olympic medals. One of the best coaches around, and he is now our provincial team coach. I'm 20 years old at this point. Most of my friends are at least halfway done university. I'm also costing my family thousands and thousands of dollars every single year just to ski moguls and give this dream a shot. So all that's starting to weigh on me at this point. Growing up, if you'd ever asked me what I wanted to be when I grow up, I would always say a professional skier. And at this point, I believe in myself a lot. Knew that I had it in me, just never had the right chance, the right shot. If you look at the last 2 seasons of NORAMS, you can see that clearly did not go my way. But still deep down, I really believed in myself. Obviously, it was hard when all your friends are almost finished university and watching them seem to be moving forward so much in their lives. But one quote that always really helped me out was from Murray Clough. He said, "You'll never regret a year you spent skiing." And I don't know why that one always sticks with me, but that's one that has always helped me stick with it and helped me really believe in myself. Because honestly, why would you ever regret a year you spent skiing? At that point, I decided to give it another chance, give it all I got. One last big try, one last kick at the can, as they say. Yeah, I decided to go all in for it, train really hard all summer long. Do everything I can in my power to set me up in a good position to make national team for the next year. Coming into the first event of the year, selections at Apex, feeling pretty good. And I end up winning selections. That was probably one of the points where I knew that this is something that I really could do. Like, I could really grab the bull by the horns and make this goal of mine a reality. Going into NORAMS this year, I'm feeling pretty confident. First NORAM of the year is in Stratton, and I end up getting 34th in singles and 9th in duels. Going to the second NORAM of the year, yeah, I get 12th in singles and end up having to pull out of duels because I crashed coming out of top air and fall on a mogul kind of like underneath my shoulder, and I end up tearing my rotator cuff. And I wasn't able to lift my arm above like even shoulder height when I first did it. Going into the last two NORAMS of the year, shoulders feeling better, still obviously not 100%. It had only been 2 weeks at that point, but I found ways to work around it. I still couldn't lift my arm all the way above my head, but mogul skiing is just right here anyways, so there's ways to get around it. Obviously not ideal. We're going into Steamboat, a course I've never skied before, in Colorado, and I end up getting 59th in singles and 19th in duels. So clearly at this point, these are not the results on the NORAM tour that I need to make the team. One contest left at Apex this year. Going to Apex knowing that I need to put something down to get a result. Looking back now, my entire career really did rest on this one event. If it did not go well, I would not make it to national team and I would not end up skiing another year most likely. So this was a huge event for me. Last NORAM of the year, again at Apex, course that I had won selections on earlier that year, feeling pretty confident on that course. And in singles, I end up getting 11th, which it makes finals, but it's not like standout amazing result. And then going into duels is a day where I knew I really had to take control of my own destiny in this one. And this is the last chance that I had to make national team to make my goals become a reality. I end up finishing third at Apex in duels. So I got a podium, and I later on talked to people about that. And yeah, it's true that if I did not get a podium at that event, that I would not have made national team. So very lucky on that one to have been able to pull through for that event. After getting that third, a few months go by. I'm hanging out in the springtime, packing up all my stuff, about to go on a camping trip with Haley and go surfing in Tofino. We end up leaving Calgary and start driving. This is when I get a call from Jim, who is now the head coach of the development team, and he tells me that I made the team. This is now pretty much a year ago to the day that this all happened. I could not be more proud and more thankful of where I am and the opportunities that I've been presented with. A huge thanks to everybody who's helped me get here. Definitely would not have been able to do it all on my own. Within this last year, I won my first NORAM. I got third out of NORAM. I finished fifth overall on the NORAM tour. After the season, I'm healthy, more motivated than ever to work hard, put myself out there, and do the best that I can in skiing and in these videos. Comment below what you guys think of this style of video if you want me to do any more story times like this. I'm super excited to share this journey with you guys. I hope you guys are as invested as I am, and let's see where we can take this.